Hi there, Doug Stewart with IT Creations, with the 2U Dell PowerEdge R550 Rack Server. Not new, just new-ish. As always with Dell, there is a single model number that gets a new digit as an upgrade featuring the next-gen processors. This is a 15th generation server by Dell standards. If they released a PowerEdge R560, then we would be talking about the 16th generation, but that hasn't happened yet. Remember, this video is from the end of 2024. This unit supports 3rd generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors with up to 24 cores. If you like our videos, hit that subscribe button. Notifications? I didn't think so. Let's move on. You guessed it, the 14th generation Dell PowerEdge R540 only supports 2nd gen Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs. With support for 3rd gen on the PowerEdge R550, Dell is kicking it up a notch. Who knows, maybe the next generation version, they'll jump right over the 4th and 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs and go right for the Intel Xeon 6. I do wonder if they would have to call that one the 17th generation system. Maybe an R570? Anyways, crazy how quickly these CPUs are being released. This is a general purpose server designed to support small business workloads and light virtualization, plus video streaming and surveillance, to name a few. It's also designed to be cost effective. 3rd gen Intel Xeon Scalable processors will deliver 8 to 40 physical cores each, but this system is limited to only 24 cores per socket to offer small to medium-sized businesses exceptional value. On the front of the system, you can either go sans bezel or install an optional Dell honeycomb bezel. There's either the security version or one with an integrated LED panel for some management at chassis using the arrow keys. You can also get the integrated Dell Remote Access Controller IP address on that little screen. To the left, a small control panel with LED status lights for drives, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCIe cards. The long button functions as a system health and system ID button. iDRAC QuickSync 2 is also an option and provides at-chassis management of the system using a smartphone or tablet with the OpenManage mobile app for iOS or Android systems. Available at your local online app store. Are you interested in the 2U Dell PowerEdge R550 server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at itcreations.com that's listed at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information. And when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video, itcreations.com. The other control panel on the right has the power on button, a USB port, VGA port, and iDRAC Direct port right at the bottom. There are a few different storage configurations for this chassis. We have the 3.5-inch chassis with 8 3.5-inch storage bays. An optional slimline optical drive can be installed above that first drive bay on the left. Other chassis options include 2.5-inch 8-bay and 16-bay drive support. All configurations are compatible with SAS and SATA drive types. NVMe drives are not supported unless we're talking about a BOS to boot the system. Optional boot optimized storage subsystem, or BOS S2, would go right there above the PSUs. The BOS preserves those upfront drives with support for the operating system or a hypervisor. It offers support for one or two M.2 drives that can be used in a RAID 0 or a RAID 1 configuration. RAID 0 for speed and performance, or RAID 1 to mirror the drives for redundancy. PSU support on the system includes 600 watt, 700 watt, 800 watt, and 1100 watt options. On top, PCIe slots 1, 2, 5, and 6, with a system ID button nestled in between 5 and 6. Below that, a VGA port, then an OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slot, which we have filled with a 1 gig base T OCP 3.0 NIC with quad RJ45 ports. Then a USB 3.0 port and a USB 2.0 port with dedicated iDRAC remote management port. Two integrated gigabit Ethernet ports for basic network communications. Nice that there are a few ways to manage the system using iDRAC. For at-chassis management, you have the optional LED bezel, or you can use Dell's QuickSync 2 on the left control panel. Alternatively, you can use a laptop through the iDRAC Direct port or with a keyboard and mouse using the ports on the right control panel. For remote management, the dedicated RJ45 gigabit Ethernet management port on the back of the system. I did a short overview of iDRAC 9 and you can see it right here. Inside the system, we have dual 3rd generation gold Intel Xeon Scalable 5317 CPUs with 12 cores each and a TDP of 150 watts. TDP on the R550 is limited to 165 watts. There are only 7 CPUs to choose from, and that includes 3 Gold Series and 4 Silver Series 3rd Gen Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs. To either side of the CPU sockets are 4 memory module slots for 16 total with both processors installed. With 8 memory channels per CPU and 16 memory module slots each, memory module occupies its very own memory channel for optimal performance at up to 2933 megatransfers per second. We have 16 registered 32 gigabyte DDR4 memory module slots for 512 gigabytes total. The system does cap off at 1 terabyte of memory using 64 gigabyte memory modules in all slots. Dell has studied how their systems are typically configured for small to medium-sized businesses and found that many customers only install about 1 terabyte of memory, hence the somewhat pared-down platform. The system features 4 low-profile, half-length PCI slots for expansion. No risers. Instead, the expansion cards plug directly onto the motherboard. Another cost-saving feature. Slots 1, 5, and 6 are PCI 4.0 and have a x16 slot width. Slot 2 is running off the PCH and has a x4 slot width and a PCI 3.0 interface. Those slots are for additional PowerEdge RAID controllers or network interface controllers, of which several options are available. Also quite a few offerings for that OCP card with various link speeds and ports. GPUs are not supported on this system. The S150 Perk is a software-based RAID controller that's built in and offers limited RAID support. We have a Dell Perk H755 front RAID controller that mounts in a dedicated spot right on top of the drive cage with easy access to the drive backplane. This is a Perk 11 controller with 8 gigabytes of DDR4 cache memory and provides 6 gigabit per second throughput for SATA and 12 gigabit per second for SAS-3. PCI SSD NVMEs are also supported by this Perk H755 at 8 to 16 gigatransfers per second with a x2 lane width. It does not support mixing of NVMe with other drive types and offers RAIDs of 0, 1, 5, 6, 10, 50, and 60. I will remind you at this point, no NVMe drives are supported on this platform aside from the BOSS, which is hardware RAID enabled already. The Perk H755 has a battery to provide emergency power in the event of power loss. This ensures any data in the cache is properly stored so it's not lost or corrupted. Dell is targeting the needs of medium to small businesses with the PowerEdge R550 server that's right-sized and as a result a bit more affordable for a number of common business applications. You don't get support for the full core counts provided by higher-priced CPUs, nor the full memory support at only 16 memory module slots. That'd be compared to like a high-density system that might support 40 cores per CPU and have 32 memory module slots and larger capacity modules at that. In some ways, this platform is similar to that RS660XS server I posted a few weeks back. Just right. If you are interested in this server, I placed a few links in the description below, or you can use that one right there to learn more. ITCreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.